Okay, we have two very similar Riemann sums on the spot. For the first one, we have an N on the top. But for the second one, we have an I on the top. And we have done a lot of Riemann sum examples. So I will have a video in the description for your convenience. You guys can review that first. And then you know the deal. Please pause the video and try these two questions first. All right. Now let's go ahead and get right into it. Here is the deal. I will give you guys a quick review. Note, whenever we have the limit as n goes to infinity and then the summation, let's use I for the index if it goes from 1 to n. And then if we have f of x sub I, this right here is just the function, and xi just means that we have different x values. We plug in and then we can get the height of the rectangles. Right, so f of xi is just the height of the rectangle. And then the width is x, delta x, like this. And sometimes you may see this right here has a little star. That means the width might not be equal, but you don't have to worry about that too much. All right, when we have this, here are some of the things that you have to pay attention. Delta x, the width of each rectangle is b minus a over n. We're using equal width rectangles. And then for the xi, here is the deal. We are going to start with a, and we are going to add it with I, which is just like the counting index, and then multiply by the width of each rectangle. So what exactly does this mean? Well, this translates to an integral going from a to b. That's what the a and b were for. And then of course we will have our function f of x, and the delta x will be the dx, which is like the super version of the width of the rectangle. So as long as we can convert these two limits of Riemann sums to integrals, then we'll be able to calculate them. So that's the strategy. So keep this in mind. And now let me show you guys how we can do it. The key here is that pay attention to the xi. You want to squeeze out that part. And usually, you want to get the I over N somewhere, all right? So for the first one, notice that we have I squared, and then we have N squared here. If we divide the top and bottom by N squared, then we will be able to have I over N in the parentheses and then square. So that's the idea, all right? So here, this is equal to the limit as N goes to infinity. And here's usually how we like to write it. We have n over n squared on the top, and they have no I, right? So we can put that in the front of the summation. So I'm just going to write it as 1 over n here, and then we write down the summation. I goes from 1 to n, and then we just have the 1 on the top now over, and we have n squared over n squared is just 1 plus I squared over n squared, so we can write it as I over n squared. Great. Here, usually pay attention to this part first. We have 1 over n, right? The 1 here tells us b minus a is equal to 1. So the limits of the integration can go from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, or 5 to 6, etc, etc. And usually, I will tell you, just start with 0. It's easier that way. And go ahead and check out my other videos for more examples that if it does not start with 0. Alright, so keep that in mind. Start with 0, going to 1. And then here we have that I over n, right? That's the x. Then that's exactly this part, f of xi. So here is the deal. This right here is actually just the same as integral going from 0 to 1, and the function is 1 over 1 plus x squared, and then we have the dx. And now once we have the integral, integrate this real quick. The integral of 1 over 1 plus x squared is inverse tangent of x, and then plugging, right? 0 and 1, 1 goes first, inverse tangent of 1, and then minus inverse tangent of 0. Inverse tangent of 1 is pi over 4. inverse tangent of 0 is 0. So the answer is just pi over 4. All right, now let's take a look at the second one. What should we do though? Well, let's try the same thing. Because again, we still want to see that I over n. So let's go ahead and divide the top and bottom by n squared. All right, so here I'm just going to do like this. This is the limit as n goes to infinity. And now on the top, it's a little bit trickier. Notice that we have the n squared, right? I'm still going to put down a 1 over n right here, like this. All right, and then we have that summation. I goes from 1 to n. And then the bottom is the same as what we had earlier, which is 1 plus parentheses I over n squared. And for the top, it was I over n squared, and then we have the 1 over in the front, yeah? So we need I over n, because this and that multiply will give us the I over n squared. And now, same thing like what we did earlier, pay attention to the I over n part, that will give us the x, and because we have the 1 here, 1 over n, so that means b minus a is equal to 1, and let's just start with 0. So this is just the integral going from 0 to 1. And here we have x over 1 plus x squared dx. So this is the integral. And then to finish this, we can do a u sub, let u equal to 1 plus x squared du equals 2x dx, and so on, so on, so on. Perhaps I will finish everything for you guys. Dx equals du over 2x. And these are the x values. So once we take this integral to the u world, well, u will be going to plugging 0 in here. We get 1 plus 0 squared, which is just 1. And plugging 1 into here, 1 plus 1 squared is 2. So u goes from 1 to 2. And then we see that we have the x over 1 plus x squared is u, and then dx is du over 2x. And the x and x cancel, and we can finish everything in the u world. We have the 1 over 2 as a factor. Let's just multiply that. Let's put that in front. Integrating, u goes from 1 to u 2, 1 over u du. And this is just going to be 1 over 2 ln. You don't need the absolute value because we are just going from 1 to 2. So this is 1 over 2 ln 2 minus 1 over 2 ln 1. And ln 1 is 0. So final answer is just 1 over 2 ln 2. And that's it. These two are two very similar Riemann sum limits and convert them to integrals. That's it.